This is John with Greenfish Nation. Welcome to the channel today. Today we're going to talk about stick baits and the five ways that you should be rigging them to fish this spring. If you're not using one of these methods, you're missing out. So stay tuned for stick baits on Greenfish Nation. Guys, stick baits have been around for as long as I can remember. The original stick bait was the Gary Yamamoto Senko. There are many, many other brands of stick baits and different sizes, weights, colors, diameters, you can just imagine. But today we're going to go over a few ways that we find successful rigging these stick baits. So we're going to go over our top five methods. All right, guys, method number one, I'm going to take a wide gap hook, extra wide gap hook here, with a screw lock spring on it. And I'm gonna put a stick bait on here. This just happens to be by Big Bite Bait Company. I'm gonna screw that on there. Try to get that thing in there good and straight, cause that's what's gonna give you the best action out of this bait. And if you'll notice, it has a little hook slot here in the top. So I'm gonna try to get that turned exactly like I need it to come out of that hook slot. We'll turn it a little bit more, get that screw lock buried up in there good. We'll try to bring that hook out right on top, get it nice and straight. I'm gonna get it straight like this right here, guys. Try to bring that. I like to keep that hook just inside there. That way I'm perfectly weedless, because I'm going to be fishing here at one of my little ponds that I grew up fishing on as a kid, throwing this exact bait. Try to keep it weedless. It has a lot of water hyacinth and a lot of water lilies in it. So you guys stay tuned and we'll show you some action on the old straight stick bait. Straight rig stick bait. We're gonna give it a try. This has always been a pretty productive spot. Just to pitch out there and just work a Senko or something back to the bank, just slow and easy. It's always been pretty good. There we go. Pulled him right off there. Straight rig stick bait. He's a little cuss, but he got him. He got him a little bite. He ain't much bigger than the bait. Let's see if we can come up with another one. Cross and see what we can do. Oh, there we go. There we go. He ain't very big, but he don't know it. Did you guys see how he come out of that water over there? Got him a mouthful of it. A little better than the last one. This is the shallow end. See what we can't drag up over here. There we go, guys. Must have thrown it right in his mouth. Oh, he got off on us. Hey guys, the next way that I want to show you how to rig a Senko, we're going to go with a watermelon red this time. That one's already been used. So we're going to go with a watermelon red this time. And what I have here is a 1/16 ounce ball head jig. If you guys can see that. It does have a weed guard on it right here. So we are going to be going weedless. I'm going to rig it wacky style. I do not use any O-rings or anything. I want to be right in the middle of the bait. And this just makes that wacky worm fall a little faster. So you guys stay tuned. Let's see what we can get on this weighted wacky rig. There we go, guys, right there. I'm telling you, it don't take long. First cast on a weedless, weighted, wacky rig. I want you to look at that, would you? Son, that right there is a red-eared bream right there now. Bit of 6-inch weighted, wacky rig stick bait. Man had him about 20 of them. He could make a mess of fish. There we go, guys. That's what we're looking for. Ain't a monster, but he's a good one. All right, guys, our next way that we rig our Senkos, I like to fish them on a drop shot. You can see I got a little drop shot hook here, little weight there. Got about a 12 inch leader on it from the hook to the weight. Here I've got about 12 inches. Now you can rig this two ways. I've got this on a weedless hook. You can nose hook it, or you can wacky rig it. I'm probably going to wacky rig this one right behind the egg sack. I'm going to set my weed guard up where I want it. I like for that to just barely be on there, but anyway, that's a sweet potato pie stick bait. So you guys, let's see what we can do on this drop shot, wacky rig sweet potato pie. There we go, guys. There's one on the old sweet potato pie drop shot. Another little buck bass. See if I can get him lipped here. Stuck him right in the top of the mouth there. Another little buck bass. Sweet potato pie drop shot. All right, guys, our next setup, be setup number 3. We're gonna be throwing this Senko on a Ned head, weedless Ned head. You could do it one of two ways. You can throw the whole Senko, or you can break you off a little piece. I think that's what I'm going to do, is I'm going to break it off right here, right behind the egg sack. Put that in my pocket. I don't want to leave any trash out here where I'm fishing. I'm going to thread that little dude right onto my hook here. Make sure it's good and straight. Set my weed guard. Make sure it's good and straight. And we're going to go fishing. Stephanie caught about a 7-pounder right here last year about this time on a... There we go. There you go. There's the Ned rig for you. Come here, you little scoundrel. Get back up here. There's a little one on the Ned rig, guys. I think that was maybe the third cast. So, ain't real big, but we're out here trying to demonstrate how to use these Senkos. So you guys stay tuned for our next way of rigging a Senko. All right, guys, that's 4 out of the 5 ways here. We've covered just a straight rig Senko on an extra wide gap screw lock hook. We got a couple bites on it, but weren't able to capitalize on bringing anything in. Then we went to let's see, what did we go to next? We went to a weighted wacky rig. You can also fish a weightless wacky rig. I fished at next with a drop shot, and we also fished a half a Senko on a Ned rig. Last thing we're going to do here is we're going to fish a Senko Texas rig. I rig it a little different probably than most people. I like to get an extra wide gap hook, as I do with most of my plastics, unless I'm flipping. I like to put that on, I got it on like some 20-pound braid. I got a little, it's quarter ounce weight. And I put a little bead on there just to kind of give it a little noise. So you guys, let's stay tuned and let's see what we can do on this Texas rigged Senko. Got off on me. Nice little fish. That probably been the biggest fish of the day. What do y'all think about that? I think that's the daddy to that mama we caught a while ago. He didn't like that thing at all in his neighborhood. Well, we're gonna try them again. Kind of working it kind of fast along top of that moss.